Now, if you combine these two free graphic design tools I'm going to show you and you use them in the way I'm going to show you today, your graphic design workflows will change forever. So I'm going to show you three ways I'm currently using two free tools in my graphic design workflows. And the first method will be shown with this design right here, which will soon become a t-shirt design as you're going to see soon. So the two free tools we're going to be using today are firstly ChatGPT and secondly Adobe Color. But trust me, you probably have not seen the smart approaches I've created when using these two tools as a designer. Okay, so for method one, the first thing I'm going to do is to ask ChatGPT to suggest a color palette for my t-shirt brand. But importantly, I want to add in some adjectives that describe the brand's style and vibe. In this instance here, I've gone for dark, mysterious, and macabre, which I feel match my project and the message or the vibe. And boom, we have choices for the color palette right here in front of our eyes. Now, this is where things start to get interesting. Copy one of the hex codes and then come into Adobe Color. We are going to look at different features on the software soon, but for now, we can simply paste in a hex code into here. You can adjust the color scheme manually, or you can make one directly from the hex codes. But once you have your color scheme, what I've been doing in my workflow is saving the scheme to my libraries, which you will soon see is hugely, hugely useful. So if you are using CC, then everything will be synced across the Creative Suite. And this is why this workflow is just so awesome. So coming back to my design here, we can open up the libraries panel and scroll down to find the relevant color scheme that we've just created. So this kind of workflow is so easy to use in Adobe Illustrator because we just open up the swatches panel, then right or control click the scheme here and add it to our swatches via the themes. And boom, there we have it, right there, ready to use. But here in Adobe Illustrator, things get even more efficient in terms of the workflow. So we can select everything on the design, and if you want to, you can press Command or Control H to remove the highlighting of the anchor points so you can see clearly. And then come up to Edit and Recolor Artwork. But use the preset option found right here. And then we're able to directly use the exact color scheme that we made in Adobe Color. And it is a quick and intuitive way to work on this design. And finally, we have a pretty cool looking t-shirt design ready to use. So on to method number two, which gets even smarter than the previous method we just looked at. And to demonstrate, let's assume we're making a package design for a cosmetics brand. Now this brand needs to incorporate a new brand identity or style direction. This design here on screen might be the old existing previous design for the brand, or we can assume it's the competitor to our clients. So we can come into ChatGPT and we can explain that we are creating a package design for a cosmetics brand. And furthermore, the competitor to us utilizes pastel colors on their packaging. And we can go on to ask what design or art styles would be a good choice to compete with this kind of style. And ChatGPT has created some suggestions, as you can see, such as bold and vibrant, minimalist, retro, and so on. But it is important to read the descriptions and the logic the AI has given us, and also, of course, to see if any of them will actually apply to your brief and your research on the project. But once you have landed on a suggestion, for example, eco-friendly and earthy, we can come into Adobe Color, pop into the Explore tab, and copy this into the search bar. Let's say that we want to use this scheme right here. Again, we can just quickly add it to the library, or if you don't have CC, just download the JPEG so you can use it anywhere you want. But if you do have CC, Photoshop uses the same logic as Illustrator by coming into the library's menu and locating the color scheme right here. Now, what I love about this workflow in Photoshop is that yes, it's quick to find a scheme and bring it onto the canvas, but also we can change the colors so quickly from the scheme directly, as you can see I'm doing right here. This is just a quick example, but we now have a scheme that could compete with a potential competitor. But always remember to consider the brief and the research on your project. I cannot emphasize enough how important that actually is. Now, method number three, again, sees us starting in ChatGPT. And for this, I'm going to ask for keywords linked to the type of design I'm working on. In this instance, a motivational poster for women. Now, all we need to do here is grab one of the keywords. Oh, and by the way, this is the design we're going to change in terms of color. So with that keyword copied, this time we come into the trending tab in Adobe Color. Now, this is useful here because I'm working on a social media post. Trending colors and styles are relevant when it comes to social media designs, but you shouldn't consider this really for branding or logo design. Well, that's my opinion anyway. Now, paste that keyword into the search bar on the trending tab and see what comes up. You can also type in more keywords from your research if you need to, and again, be decisive and consider your project brief as well. So, add the color scheme to your library and away you go. Again, a quick example of how this could work in this kind of workflow. But if you'd like to learn more about color and graphic design, or just kind of any graphic design skills and techniques, just click a video on screen. But until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.